She was able to get danced on at night.
Yeah. She had her best take on
Lance Storm.
Which begs the question, like, why are they making Lance Storm bigger than Austin?
I don't know. Foxy, the Mirror Universe is weird, okay? They make somehow, maybe someone in the Ultimate Universe rates Lance Storm. That doesn't feel right. No, it could be right. I mean, they did have him as double champion for like 6 months, so maybe there is a point there to be made.
Notice how like these games are the only chance that like certain lads get put over, because they won't be put over on TV.
Yes. Like, there's still people waiting to this day for the Sean Stasiak push, and it'll never happen. Never, ever happen.
Like, yeah, we have this person, like, you won't see them on TV, but like they'll be in the game and we'll put them over strong in it.
Like,
that means nothing.
Like Vito and Johnny Stambouli.
Vito deserved to be like just off TV.
Yeah, he deserved to be jettisoned into the fucking sun.
Absolute salt of the earth.
No, he salts the earth.
He's there to make sure the earth was scorched. And just to make sure that it doesn't grow back.
Is he the most unpleasant import we ever had?
Who? One of them.
Yeah. Who? I'm still thinking TJ is that.
Vito. Big Vito.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. He did a cross-dressing gimmick. That's what got him over in SmackDown.
He got him over so much that he got his release.
Yeah. Most unpleasant to deal with? Would be Grandmaster Sexy.
I can imagine that.
Middle of the dead. Yeah. We've reached a point here now.
I do give a flying fuck. I always base how people like treat me or treat people through my interaction. And it's just, no, his wasn't a pleasant one.
Yeah, no, I get that. No, I can understand that. I think it was really funny. Someone had said to me before, there was a particular person who had passed away that I knew very well. Like, I knew this person very, very well. And everyone was like, oh my God, I'm so sorry for your loss and stuff like that. And I was like, yeah, thank you, like, sort of thing. And then it got to a point where it's like, I was with two of my best friends. And they were like, how awkward is this for you that you have to pretend that he was like a nice guy? And I'm like, oh, I've actually just stopped now at this point. And I turned around, someone had said it to me again. It's like, I'm so sorry for your loss. I'm like, do you know what? I'm not. He was a piece of shit. And if he's not in hell, he deserves to be. And I just left it and walked away. And it's just like, yeah, no, it's that whole, like, just because you've died, it doesn't automatically like absolve you from the shitty piece of human excuse of a human and waste of oxygen that you were.
Another example of bad interactions is a guy called Sam Elias. And for anyone that does not know, he is the brother of Corey Graves.
Oh, I did not know that.
Yes. And we had him for main stage a couple of years back. For a show.
Oh, I don't remember. Yeah.
That must have been fucking fun.
You're right not to remember him. Like,
I don't think Corey remembers him.
Terrible. But yeah. You wouldn't normally interrupt or interfere, like, if they're planning a match. He had a match with Bruiser. Now,
poor bastard.
Bruiser can be difficult to work with, but this is one of the good days. This is one of the good days where, like, because Bruiser was the champion at the time.
Yeah.
Main stage. Well, they were trying to figure out how to get into a certain situation. And Elias was so like dead set on like coming up with, but me being the referee, I'm just like, well, what if you did this, and that way you could transition to this? He's like, no, I'll think of it myself.
Oh, yeah, he's just, the referee's a fucking object to him, like.
In front of everyone, though. Like, in front of everyone. Like, which is not, like, not nice.
I can see why he doesn't get bookings.
Yeah, he gets bookings in Mexico, but, like, that's a...
That's Mexico.
He probably won't see him in the States.
Yeah.
Well, like, he was doing the whole, like, Trump supporter in Mexico.
That's him! Yes. I know who you're talking about now. That's the guy. I didn't realize he flew over here.
Yeah.
Ah, right. Oh, yeah, he's a massive prick. Wasn't he, like, involved... He wasn't even involved in something as well?
Like, no, he just flew over for that one show.
Oh,
but, hey. Yeah. But even, like, Bruiser is just, like... No, he was being a dick. Like, there's no need for that. Like, it's different when you, like... If you interrupted him...
Yeah.
To give your suggestion. But the fact that, like, he was openly, like...
Openly knew, like, he knew better than you. That's what it was. It was literally just like, yes. A big dog. Yeah.
Yes. Which is not right, considering... And this was before I put on the short. So...
Oh, no, he never knew.
Yeah.
Oh, so, he must have got a fucking very big surprise when he was like, what's this prick doing?
Oh. He changed his tone when he seen the short. He realized I wasn't actually being a dick. Like, I was actually trying to help him. Like, genuinely trying to help. But he'd already sealed his fate, basically. It's like,
So you probably gave him absolutely nothing in that match.
I'm not afraid to admit it. It's like, no. Fuck you. You want to be a fucking hardball, then, right? I'm going to fuck you over.
In the nicest possible way.
Yeah. Like, I won't motherfuck him, but I definitely fucked him over.
Yeah.
So. Normally, like, whether I and the way I do it is that, like, normally I'll work with anyone. I'll try and work out situations to help them get over.
Yeah.
I purposely didn't do it for him. Like, and I was very, like, strict on the rules when it came to him.
Very good.
So, that's the way I actually do it. Some people, if you're listening, yeah, it may seem a bit mean, but unfortunately, some people deserve it.
To be fair, like, there's a lot more, like, mean things that happen in the wrestling business than just the referee, like, standing up for himself. Let's be fair, like... Oh, you're like a referee with a backbone. What a cruel man you are to not let this wrestler live out his dream of being a prick. You know?
Fuck me for doing my job. Like,
yeah, exactly. Oh, fuck off.
Sorry, I have to tell you to go home. Like, sorry, I have to fucking, like, give you a time to finish the match.
Cody.
Like, can we just turn this into the fucking show where I shoot on people?
You know what?
The statute of limitations will run off on this.
It will probably be a bit more entertaining for people because one of the hosts of Nerds R Us is literally just reading Tumblr at this point. You're like venting. You're venting. I'm living in a dream world right now for two fictional fucking characters. And Jonathan is just drinking the night away thinking, this is what my Sunday has become. we're not doing our RPG. Literally just in each other's companies doing the same thing we would have done had we not been on a Zoom call.
Pretty much, yeah. So they're just going like, this is content.
I'm not joking. I actually would have really liked to do the RPG tonight. I really would have. I want to get the non-canon one out of the way. I think...
I don't know if, you see, again, by the time this comes out, I don't know if it's gonna be. It's, we've kind of missed the window for it, but we will do a non-canon episode. They're actually quite fun.
Yeah, no, I think the shit thing about the non-canon one that I had planned is as much as I wanted, I never actually got to do anything for it because everything went to shit on me.
Yeah.
Like, with my medical wise, everything went to shit. So it never, I wasn't able to actually do the stuff that I wanted to do for it. Because we were supposed to do that RPG, but I couldn't log in onto the call at all.
Yes,
and because of everything else, I wasn't able to actually put it together either. Because Jonathan had asked me if I needed help, and I was like, yeah, this is the stuff I'm going to need help with. And then when it came to the point where I would have actually been organizing it and writing it, I couldn't physically do it. I couldn't lift it, for Christ's sake.
Yeah. The handy thing is, like, you could still do it, because the theme that you picked can still work regardless.
Nah, it was a Valentine's Day feel team. It was all meant to accumulate on Valentine's Day.
You can still do
which up. And I got distracted by a fictional wedding, so between two characters.
To be fair, we can still
one
do it.
One of whom
it,
was gay,
like...
and one of whom is bi. So
actually, I'm just thinking here. We can still do it if like Kratos doesn't realize. Oh, sorry.
Kratos doesn't realize, and then you just froze, like
yes.
Kratos would.
What I was going to say there was, it's just like, we can still do it if Kratos doesn't realize that it's actually the 14th of February, not like 14th of March or something. He like, doesn't even know what day Valentine's Day is.
You can play that into it. It's like,
yeah, exactly.
You're like last month, like, you're a bit late to that.
Yeah, I could do that.
So, yeah. When there's a will, there's a way, lads, is what we're trying to say.
Oh,
if we want to get this done, we will. We will contrive
a
way to do
it. I'll figure something out. I'll figure something out, but I will be back in a second. I'll be back in a second.
Right. Myself and Foxy are just going to keep shooting on people now.
Hey. So,
look at that dreadful tag team match. Fucking hell. Rhino and Taker as a tag team. Jesus Christ.
Well, that's a dangerous one.
That's a bad tag team. That's just fundamentally wrong on all counts.
That's dangerous. Like that's a proper just like, yeah, no one's messing with that. That's basically APA. That's twice now.
it's having a day.
Yeah. But yeah, like some of them I can't talk about because like honestly they're currently in trouble. So.
Uh-huh. Yep. What we'll do
I'd rather not add to,
add fuel to
I'd
the
rather
fire.
Not add to the fucking like, the fire.
I like that.
So I'm trying to think of people that like aren't in major trouble. So
can you think of people who everyone knows are assholes?
Sabre Jr.
Oh dear, yeah.
Sorry, don't let Paul Tracy hear me say that. Jesus.
I don't say. I don't think you're getting the knock at the door there. Like.
But yeah, I didn't find him. I didn't find him very pleasant to deal with. So,
yes.
Well. No. You've seen one of his matches, you've seen them all.
Yeah, that's kind of my get as well.
Sabre Jr.
Oh, yeah. Although he has got a fucking jawline that can cut glass.
Well, yeah.
Did I say that out loud?
I did say that out loud.
He does, though, like, to be fair, that is a sharp jawline. No, that's not. That's legit just actually an observation on this one. He has got a jawline that it's very sharp.
Yeah.
Looking. Like it looks like it would be painful.
Maybe it is.
Like,
it's like when you get, you know, when you find people with those real bony fucking elbows. And just like, there's too much bone. There's too much jawbone there, and it's just like it's very pointed, and you're just like, he could like go like that to you on like your shoulder, and it would hurt.
Can I just point out that it's Amy that said the phrase "too much bone"? I just want to leave that, I'm not gonna say
there is a limit to how much bone you can take.
Just throw it into the ether there and just let's see where that sits.
Can't take the ball.
All I'm saying, sometimes too much fun is actually a thing. And it's not comfortable for anyone involved.
So
sometimes the bone just doesn't fit.
It's almost on the same level as the previous recording we did with the end. And
bigger is not always better.
Something along those lines, yeah. Because every now and then we just have to have these type of conversations with Amy to see what a wonderful, colorful life she's lived.
Yeah, sure.
I tell you, one of the funniest though people that I've actually interacted with is ACH.
Yeah, you told us it before. Yeah.
Yeah. I didn't know if I'd done it on this show, so.
Oh no, I think you told us in person, but you never put it out into the ether that ACH.
I think you told us in real life. That this isn't real life, but I think you have actually told us in real life that you think he's a cool person.
Yeah. Yeah. His sense of humor, you wouldn't expect it for someone like him. You would think he'd be super offended about certain things, but he's the one making the jokes, which makes it even more funny.
That's it. Yeah, but that's also when it's acceptable to the rule. For example, when I make jokes of when I make the sexist jokes about myself, that's why it's acceptable. It's self-depreciation. Self-deprivation.
Which is why me and Boxy have to keep our mouth shut or else the channel just fucking closes down for good.
Yeah.
Pretty much, yeah. Oh, yeah, you're just a normal monster. No, you're allowed to make a dick joke, but you have to make sure that you're literally making it at your own expense. Then it's acceptable.
Well, then I would make too many dick jokes.
Dick hair monster.
I would make dick jokes, Amy, but they're too short.
Yeah.
So.
Hey, see, you get it.
Yeah.
Are you trying to get sponsored?
Yeah.
No. Why would you say that?
Huh?
Why would you say that? I'm not trying to get sponsored.
But seriously, it's unacceptable, lad, to be doing that type of thing. Really, it's just not on to be trying to do the whole sponsorship thing and trying to put all your brands just on like that. It's ridiculous. So why'd you do that?
Please sponsor.
I don't have any with me. I don't have any with me.
We could do it the money, or at least a case of Monster. That'd be nice.
I don't know. I wonder if Monster realized that all of Irish wrestling literally is fueled by it. From the referees, God.
To
the
be
promoters,
fair,
to the wrestlers, to the fans.
To the fans. Honestly, lads.
Believe me, we have actually tried in the past to get the sponsors for a show.
Yes.
Six. I have six. There are six empty cans of Monster sitting on my nightstand right now. Four of them are Mango Loco, and then two of them are the Pacific Punch.
Very nice. Very nice.
To the extent where actually, I will say this, don't even dare say that you don't like Monster. This is actually also the thing. I've drank so much Mango Loco that I'm now vaping Mango. The vape that I'm using at the moment is Mango Ice.
I thought this was going to go a different direction completely. I thought you were going to say I've drank
you
enough.
I'm considering going on to, there's a particular website that I can go on to that does vape juices, and they do a Monster flavor of vape juice. But it's always out of stock. It's always sold out, which I haven't been able to try it yet. So considering the fact that it's always sold out, it's clearly a popular choice sort of thing. So yeah. I would imagine that it does actually taste the way it's supposed to taste. So.
There's only, obviously some of the flavors are very hard to get in. And obviously you have an import charge, but
yeah,
ones that my favorite of all time is Chaos, and that's recently after getting redeveloped, so
okay.
They've kind of rebranded it as a slightly different name, but still very nice.
Mule, Monster Mule.
No.
Was honest to God, that was a that one for me. I see. I love Ginger.
I
adore Ginger. I do, and that one is up in my top. That's one of my top five, top three.
So apart from Chaos, there's another one that it's hard to get over here, but it's called Assault. And Assault basically is like their.
Is that the one in the black? Is that the one that's in like the black can? With the red writing.
Black can with red, and it's like
camouflage.
Camouflage, yeah.
Yeah.
Very tasty.
Dunn's around my area always has that.
Look at you.
But only, and then this is the thing recently, because now they've recently started stocking the Pacific Punch one as well. Mm. Which is happy fucking days for me, because I'm on my lunch break, my hour lunch break, and I'm like, all right, I'll go out for my walk for the hour, because I can just eat at my desk at any time I want. So I set out, like, I know what times Dunn's is like really busy now during the days, and so like I go out for my walk, and then I make sure that when I'm coming back home, I have to double round, so I have to go through the shopping center so I can go in and stock up on cans of Monster, because now they do the Mango Loco and the packs of four, and they do the punch, the pink pipeline punch. Monster in packs of four now as well in Dunn's, and then I pick them up then. Yeah, that's happy days. It's a shame now it doesn't give me energy anymore, but it helps me go to sleep. You know.
No, it doesn't help me go to sleep, but like it just keeps me up for the day.
Mm. So. Yeah, no, I can drink I think I drank like 3 cans today. And in the space of 4 hours, and it's had no effect on me whatsoever. My heart, I've been checking like my heart rate and stuff, like with the Fitbit and things, and it hasn't changed at all. I think my body has just gone to my body has more issues. My body, if I don't have caffeine, my body will have the reaction to it. Like I will actually start going through like withdrawals.